Americana is a Nigerian word that means a person who's gone to the US and comes back to Nigeria and suddenly has all of these affectations. You know, pretends not to understand Nigerian languages, speaks with an American accent, you know, that kind of thing. Kind of a funny way of making fun of people who do that. And it's kind of mild here. It's well-intentioned. There's nothing ugly about, it's not derogatory really. And I thought it would be fun and interesting to have that as the title of the book, because obviously it's different. And it's not really a word in the dictionary. So I realized that nobody would be able to translate it. So then the title of the book would be the same everywhere. The main character, Ifemelu, leaves Nigeria, goes to the US, and spends many, many years there, goes back to Nigeria. And when she goes back to Nigeria, she's kind of Americana, but not quite. And for me, the Americana doesn't just mean the character, it means the idea that America is an idea, is central in this book, because America is a place that represents something to this generation of Nigerians who, they're not hungry, they're not dying of AIDS or poverty or war, but they're dreaming of America as this extra place that, you know, where magical things happen and they all want to go to America. One of the things that I found interesting and one of the reasons I wrote Americana is the question of what home means. And, you know, whether when you leave home, whether you can go back. And I think that for many people in my generation of Nigerians, home has come to mean often more than one place. I think for Ifemelu, home is Nigeria still, but it's a certain kind of Nigeria because she's changed a lot. But not only has she changed, Nigeria has changed. So when she left Nigeria, it was a certain kind of place. And then when she comes back more than 10 years later, it's a different place. And she's also a different person. In my case, I stayed away from Nigeria for 4 years before I first went back. And even then, I felt Nigeria had changed. And I felt that I had changed. But I think also that in my case, home is Nigeria. Nigeria is. And I think home can be many places. Home can also be something. Home can be the one place where you feel most, where you feel most at peace, where you feel that your heart has its roots. And for me, that's Nigeria. But also, I like to be able to leave Nigeria from time to time. So America is also a kind of home. But you know, for me, just the general idea of home is a very interesting subject, particularly now that we live in this globalized world where people are interconnected, but also they're not, in a way. And yeah, so home is, I think home is one of the major ideas of Americana. I wanted to write about many things, a love story. I wanted to write about race, because I think race is an important subject, particularly in America. And I think race is the subject that Americans are most uncomfortable about. And race is something I discovered in America. Because when I was in Nigeria, I didn't think of myself as black. And then I went to the US and I became black. And it was a learning process for me. And it was even more interesting because it wasn't just discovering that I had this new identity. Because in Nigeria, I identified as Igbo, which is my ethnic group, and I identified as Christian, which is my religion, and that's how, those are the basics of identification in Nigeria. But then in the US, suddenly black, you know, I was sort of a black person. And it was interesting to me because I realized that to be black meant something in America, and often it meant things that were not very positive. And so trying to make sense of that, I think is something that's also part of Americana. Ifemelu discovers she's black, and she starts watching and observing and learning, and then she starts writing this blog about race. And she's making fun of a lot of things, and she's saying many of the things that Americans are kind of not allowed to say. So race was important, but immigration was important because I think that many of the stories of immigration that I think the mainstream Western world knows about Africans is the kind of immigration where Africans have left poverty or AIDS or war, and where they're mostly refugees. And, you know, I think those stories are important because, you know, they matter. But it's not a story that I know personally. And I wanted to write the immigration story that I know. And it's a story of people who dream of more. So people who are middle class, they're not hungry, they have jobs, but they want to leave because they think America is this magical place where dreams happen. I think literature really matters. I think literature matters on the level of just simply reminding us of the humanity of other people. And I think that by doing that, it can make a difference. I think that if we had politicians and decision makers who all read literature, I think it would affect the way they made policy, because they would think about, not just about numbers, and they would think about the humanity of it. One of the things I love about, and it's, I should say, not just literature, but storytelling in general. And I think storytelling comes in different forms, in books, in film, even in music to an extent. And I think it really does matter. I think that it can make a difference. I think that you can read a book and it can change the way you look at the world. It can change the way you think about a particular kind of person. I think it's sad that we live in a world where literature seems to be kind of not as important, but I think it matters. And it's not just because I'm in the business of creating literature. I really think it matters.